Welcome to part two of this two-part series for Easy Agile User Story Maps. In part one, we explored the anatomy of a user story map and tips for running a user story mapping session. In part two, we'll explore how the elements of a story map are represented digitally in Easy Agile User Story Maps. We'll then dive into how teams use a story map on a weekly basis for activities such as sprint and release planning, backlog grooming, and running retrospectives. Let's dive in. Once installed, Easy Agile User Story Maps can be found in the project sidebar for every Scrum and Kanban Agile board. Clicking on the story map icon in the project sidebar will load your user story map for your selected board. If your Agile board has already been populated with issues, epics, sprints, or versions, you'll notice that on first load, the story map is pre-populated with that same data. We're now going to walk through the elements you're seeing on your screen. Lining the top of our user story map, forming what we learned in part one was called the backbone, are the epics from our Agile board. These epics will appear left to right in their rank order pulled directly from the Agile board. Each epic represents a customer activity of a user's journey through the product. For example, a fictitious Teams in Space program may have several activities across its backbone, from book commercial space travel through to onboard spacetainment. There will be an epic for each. As we learned in part one of this series, these epics should appear chronologically in the way our chosen persona would go through our product to achieve their objectives. These epics can be dragged and dropped to update their order in the backbone, and the order of the epics will be updated and reflected on the backlog using Jira ranking. We can also create new epics to add to our backbone by clicking on the Create Epic button in the top right-hand corner of the story map. New epics will appear at the end of your backbone. They can be dragged and dropped into its desired position, and the epic will also appear on your Agile board's backlog. Beneath each epic on our backbone, we see the user stories that have been linked to that epic using the standard Jira epic link. These stories appear from top to bottom in their rank pool directly from the Agile board. We can also create new stories linked to the epics in our backbone. To create a new issue on your user story map, hover over any blank space under your chosen epic and click Add New. Clicking New will open the following Quick Create box. Simply inline edit the story summary and hit Enter to continue quickly creating new stories beneath your chosen epic. Your newly created stories will now automatically have their epic link set in Jira and will also be scheduled in the sprint or version swimlane that they were created in. All of the stories you see on your user story map are those that have been linked to an epic. But what about those issues scheduled in your sprints or versions, or simply sitting unscheduled in your backlog that have not yet been linked to an epic? Issues not linked to an epic from your Agile board live in the Issues Without Epics panel. Clicking on the blue backlog icon in the top right of your story map will open this panel. You can search for issues in this panel by keyword, issue key, or quick filters, and multi-select, drag and drop them onto your story map. Dragging an existing issue from your Issues Without Epics panel will link the issue to the epic it sits under and schedule the issue into the respective sprint or version, depending on which swim lane it was dropped into. As we learn in part one of this series, user stories should be ordered top to bottom in terms of the value they deliver to customers. In Easy Agile User Story Maps, we can rearrange stories by dragging and dropping them within a swim lane and between swim lanes to show their value to our users and how we are prioritizing our work for delivery to our customers. Moving issues vertically will also update their rank on your Agile board on your Jira backlog. We're also able to change the swim lane type on our story maps by clicking on the swim lane dropdown in the top right-hand corner. When a Scrum team first opens their user story map, they will see their story map sliced horizontally by sprint swim lanes pulled directly from their Agile board. This is what we've seen here in this demo so far. Scrum teams will also have the ability to switch between sprint and version swim lanes on their story map via the swim lanes dropdown. Alternatively, when a Kanban team first opens their story map, they will see it sliced horizontally by version swim lanes pulled directly from their releases page in Jira. The versions are ordered by their release date on the story map. In both cases, teams are able to create new sprints and versions directly from the story map. To create a new sprint on the story map, first, we must make sure that the sprint swim lanes have been toggled on using the Swimlanes dropdown. Scroll to the backlog swim lane at the bottom of your story map and click Add Sprint. Name your sprint and click Submit. Your new sprint will appear above the backlog on the user story map and on your board's backlog in Jira. To create a new version on the story map, switch to Version Swimlanes using the Swimlanes dropdown. Scroll to the Backlog Swimlane at the bottom of your story map and click Add Version. Name your version and click Submit. Your new version will appear above the backlog on the user story map and at the bottom of your releases page in Jira. So far, we've looked at the anatomy of your Easy Agile user story map, from Epic Backbone to user stories and your sprint and version swimlanes. Now we're going to walk through ways of using the user story map for your sprint and release planning sessions. Perhaps one of the biggest considerations for a team when planning their sprints or releases is their capacity and ensuring that they're not overcommitting. At the end of each sprint or version swimlane on the story map, we have estimation lozenges. These lozenges show an accumulation of the estimated work planned for that sprint or version in each of the three status categories: to do, in progress, and done. Teams can then quickly update the estimate for those stories through inline editing. These estimates are automatically added to the estimation lozenges at the end of our swim lane, ensuring that we're aware of our committed capacity for our given sprint or version. We can also use these estimation lozenges to check in throughout the course of a sprint. For example, if we're halfway through a sprint, and we can see that the majority of our work still remains in the to-do or in-progress status categories, we can start to de-scope our sprint and move work into the following sprints. Teams can start and complete their sprints without having to leave the story map. To start a sprint, click on the blue Start Sprint button at the end of the top swim lane. Here, you can edit your sprint name, update the start and end date, and enter the sprint goals. Click Start Sprint. Your sprint is now active in Jira. Teams also have the ability to complete their sprints without leaving the story map. To complete an active sprint, click on the blue Complete Sprint button at the end of the active sprint swim lane. You will now see an overview of the status of issues in your sprint. Under the Move To heading, select where incomplete issues should be moved to. Then click Complete Sprint. This overview of the number of issues completed versus not completed serves as a good talking point when it comes to running a retrospective of your sprint, which we'll dive into now. In Easy Agile User Story Maps, we have the option to visualize a snapshot of our historical sprints and versions at the point when they were released or completed. This allows us to provide a more holistic view of our product to date, reflect on what was shipped in our previous releases, and facilitate retrospectives on our closed sprints by providing a glimpse of what was completed versus still in progress when we closed it out. To visualize completed sprints or released versions on our story map, click on the Swimlanes dropdown. Clicking on your desired swimlane type on the left-hand side will provide a list of available completed sprints or released versions on the right-hand side. If we wanted to run a retrospective on our last completed sprint, we would select it from the top of our list. Navigating back to the story map, we can see our last completed sprint sitting at the top of our story map in a read-only view. Having this view allows us to reflect on what we were able to achieve in our previous sprint by providing a glimpse of the state of our sprint when it was completed. In this example, we can see most of our work was in a to-do or in-progress status, which would provide a talking point to kick off our retrospective and potentially address issues of scope creep, overcommitment, estimation, and the size of work taken into the sprint. This brings us to the conclusion of this Easy Agile User Story Maps walkthrough. We covered how elements such as the story map backbone, user stories, and sprint or version slices are represented digitally on the story map. We also covered how having a digital story map acts as an integral artifact to facilitate sprint and release planning, backlog grooming, and retrospectives. For any questions, please feel free to reach out directly to our support team. We look forward to hearing from you.